What a wonderful time of life you had, first to 10th standard, year after year. Little bit of tension at the end of the year, annual exams, whatever it is. Somehow you managed, all you had to do was to pass, because regardless of how many marks you got, your teachers wrote, can do better. And your parents looked at the marks card and pointed out only to those where you scored low and said, hey, what happened in this subject? Anyway, you gave excuses and you moved on. If you have come to 10th standard, and more so if you completed 10th standard already, now is the time to really sit back and think what you are going to do in life. This is perhaps going to be the first important decision of your life, but it's going to be a very crucial decision. Because at the end of 10th, as per our education system, you come to the stage where you have to start making your choices. You have to start, you know, there are various routes and you have to select which route you are going to go into. Now, what are the options available to you after 10th? Option number one, stop studies. Sounds fantastic, but your parents won't allow you to do that. So you have to study further. Now, what do you mean by study further? There are shortcuts. You can say, oh, I saw that ad in the paper. In 3 months, I can become a hardware engineer, employment guaranteed and all that. No way. Your parents are not going to be taken in by that. They're going to say, you are an intelligent boy or girl. You've done well and you have a good future. We are going to invest in you. We are going to back you up. And you better go in for higher studies. So what does higher studies means? It means 2 years intermediate, PUC. Or plus two as it is called, and then you move on to your degrees, post-graduation, whatever it is. So now that you are at that stage where you have to take this decision about your plus two, should I take science, should I take commerce, should I take arts? If I take science, should I take biology or should I go for computer science or for electronics or stuff like that? All these questions are there in your mind. I'll give you a simple way of how you should go about it. I won't tell you that science is better than commerce or commerce is better than arts, etc. What I want you to do is to first set your long-term goals. Eventually, what do I want to be? 40 years, 50 years, I'm going to be working in my chosen career. Do I want to be an engineer, a technocrat, a guy on computers, programming, and this and that, that sort of thing? Do I want to be an outdoors person? Do I want to be in marketing or travel or this or that or international trade or something like that? Am I a creative guy? Would I be happy doing some design work and coming out with new things? So that's how you need to first set your long-term goals and then work backwards and say, what do I take now which will help me to move towards that long-term goals? Obviously, all of you are aware of the fact that if you take science for 2 more years, all options are open to you. So there are a lot of people I know who take science only because of that reason. I don't think that's a great idea. If you are taking science because you like it, you enjoy it, and yet you want to keep all the other options open, fine. If you've been scoring well and if you enjoy science and if you feel that you can, and remember, once you move from 10th to 11th, the science portions increase drastically. So if you've just been mugging up at the last moment and getting through in your maths, physics, chemistry and all that, don't get waylaid. Have a look at the 11th standard or the first PUC or first intermediate textbooks. See the volume, see the amount of studies you'll have to do. If it still appeals to you and you say yes, I think I'm going to enjoy it and I think I'm going to score well in it, then and then only you take science. Same thing with whether to take biology or not. I don't want to be a doctor, so why should I take biology? That's not the reason for selecting whatever you want. Actually speaking, whether you take electronics, whether you take computer science, whether you take information, any of those type of things, it really doesn't matter much because those are considered to be the fourth subject. As you know, in some states, they don't even have four subjects. They tell you to take either maths, physics, chemistry or physics, chemistry, biology, that's it. So though, if you belong to a state where you have four subjects, don't give too much importance to the fourth subject. Give more importance to the school or college where you are going to be, because those are your foundation years where things are going to be pretty good. Let me also tell you that it is no longer true that science students have better careers than commerce or art students. Today, commerce students, art students are competing and in some cases doing better than science students. So if you don't like science, don't force yourself to take it. Then explore commerce, arts. It's a myth that, you know, arts is only for those guys who don't study well or who can't get into anything better or something of that sort. Some of the most brilliant people nowadays are taking arts and doing a very good job of it, I must tell you. So, as I said, set your long-term goals. Now, what are your long-term goals going to be based on? They're going to be based on whether you, your personality traits, as I was telling you, the subjects that you like, what type of career, what type of job you would like to do, and lastly, your aptitude. What is aptitude? Aptitude is the potential to do well in that particular field. Do I have the traits? Do I have that skills? Do I have the type of intelligences that are required to do well in that particular field? If that is right, if that fits in, then and then only you go ahead. It should be an ideal combination of aptitude plus interest. And it should be a combination between you and your parents. What happens if your parents say that, no, there's no doctor in the family, we want you to be a doctor? Or daddy says, no, hey man, software engineers make big money, and what are you talking about, design and fashion and something else? Or you better be a software engineer. Don't get into conflict. As counselors, over the years, we have seen that you can come to an understanding with your parents without getting into fights and conflicts with them. There are ways and means of doing it.